Hi, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Alicia, if you are new here. And today I wanted to talk to you about how I used my military training to be a stay-at-home mom, homeschool mom, and a wife. So I went into the military, into the Air Force in 2008. I had just turned 21 years old, and I went into a communications/radio job. I really, really liked my job at first because it allowed me to travel all over the country. I've been to so many states and to several countries outside of the US. My dream when I joined the Air Force was to travel. That was the whole reason, other than to pay for school. I had been in college for about 3 years at that point. I was jumping around. I think I changed majors twice and took a bunch of random classes. And I just thought, man, I am wasting so much time and money. I don't want to do this anymore. So I signed up for the military, I raised my right hand, and I joined the Air Force. I did basic training at Lackland in Texas, Lackland Air Force Base in San Antonio, and I did my tech school there too. I did communications, and I learned a lot about a field that I had never, I knew obviously with car radios and hooking up electronics at home, but there was so much more to it that I didn't understand before, and I learned a lot and I enjoyed it. And I did that for about 4 years, but the deployment schedule was so intense, and there was one period where I was gone for like 10 months out of the year between two deployments and just general travel. And I thought, man, I think I was about 25 by that point, and I was really wanting to get my degree and settle down, but it was really hard to take classes while I was traveling so much. At least I needed a few classes that I had to do, where I thought I had to do at the time in person, but then I found out later I was able to do them online, surprisingly. And so I did that later. But I decided to retrain after 4 years and go into a field called chaplain assistant, which is basically working at a chapel, a religious chapel, helping with religious services and morale events. We did things like manage money for the chapel, like the offerings that people gave, as well as the appropriated or government funds that we got. Building maintenance, making sure that our buildings were good, putting in orders, work orders for other agencies on base to come look at and fix if they needed to be. It was really a jack of all trades kind of career field. My communications job was a lot more focused than a chaplain assistant, but I had my communications job outside the office, but then I was also inside an office working with things like evaluations and making sure people were caught up on their training and meeting the standards for job performance and that sort of thing. It took some time for me to learn how to apply that with children, because children are very different than trained adults, trained military people. And so it took a minute for me to kind of figure out that babies don't necessarily function on a schedule just because you put them on one. And so I had to learn that. It was a little difficult for me to adjust to having babies, but over time and research and just patience and prayer, I really learned how to apply the things that I learned as a mother as opposed to a staff sergeant, which was the highest rank that I made while I was in. And staff sergeant in the Air Force is a E5, if you're wondering. I think in other branches of the military, it's maybe an E6. I think in the Army, a staff sergeant is an E6. I could be wrong. Let me know in the comments down below. So the first way that I have used my military training to help me be a stay-at-home mom and a housewife is just simple house management. When I was chaplain assistant, we pretty much ran the chapel, and there are so many things that go into running a chapel. You have to make sure it is clean and tidy, make sure that things are stored properly, that way people know where to find them. You are also helping manage people that want to use the chapel. For example, a lot of people like using the kitchen and the fellowship hall at chapels for like for unit get-togethers, for dinners or formal events or briefings. So there's a lot of scheduling involved, a lot of making sure that people are cleaning up after themselves. You also have to make sure that people comply with rules and put things back where they're supposed to be. That way it's ready for the next event. You also deal a lot with things like contracts and contract doors, making sure that people have keys, making sure the keys come back when they're supposed to, when people no longer need them. Lots of management of a ton of different things. In our home, we have a budget that we stick to. We have finances that we manage, and I use a lot of the skills that I learned as an airman to manage those things in our home. We also have people that come and work for us. Every spring, we have a landscape company that does some work in our flower beds for us. We also have a lawn man that comes. We've had plumbers come out. So learning how to communicate and talk to people in a way that's professional and efficient and everyone understands what's going on. That may seem kind of obvious that you would just know that, but I don't know if I would have known that beforehand. I think working in a chapel helped me to communicate what I want, as well as set my expectations for myself and for the people that we're working with, and to communicate on a professional level. And to go along with that, because there are so many things that I had to manage, I really learned how to prioritize what we needed to do. Maybe before I joined the military, I was more about myself and what I wanted to do and what felt good. I was 21 when I went in, and I think most young people kind of are still figuring themselves out and life out and still figuring out how to prioritize things. Well, the military helped me learn very quickly how to prioritize. A second thing that I've learned from my time in the military is about leadership. Before, I might not have thought of mothers as leaders, but really mothers are leaders of children and of the home. And maybe other places too if they work, but for me specifically, staying home, I am a leader of my children. A few ways that I apply this. One is to delegate. Good leaders delegate, meaning you give tasks to other people, and I'm always learning new ways to delegate. When my husband started staying home more, suddenly there wasn't a huge burden to do everything on me, because I felt as if I needed to do everything because his schedule was so inconsistent because of his work, that I felt it was hard for me to ask him for stuff because I didn't want to ask him to do something, but then he's not home for it, and then I had to do it. It was just hard. So now in the mornings when he gets up, he makes the bed and he clears the table and cleans it after breakfast. And that may sound so simple, but just having those two things off my mind is so helpful to me. Very helpful. I love it. And also, I've delegated things to my children. Rather than doing everything myself, I give my children tasks to do, and they love it. The other day, I was trying to decide if I wanted to send my children outside to play or have them play inside, and then suddenly I thought, you know what? Why don't I just let them help me vacuum? I taught them how to vacuum, and they did really good vacuuming. Even though we have this old clunker, this huge vacuum cleaner, my three-year-old, who's a tiny little thing, she was able to vacuum her whole bedroom, and she actually did a really good job. I was really surprised. Not that I expected shoddy work, just I didn't think a three-year-old would do that kind of job that she did. She did really good, and so did my five-year-old. And then they worked together to make sure that the cord didn't get sucked up by the vacuum cleaner. And that kind of leads into my next point of leaders train. When I first started having babies, I was looking into different methods of parenting and ideas on how to do that. And one thing that kept coming up is child training. And I think training, teaching are kind of the same thing. It's basically teaching your child what you expect of them. And when I was teaching when I decided to let my children vacuum, I said, okay, well, here's how you do it. Don't let the cord get, I said, okay, here's how you manage it. You hold it here, put your foot here, pull down, here's how you turn it on. And don't let the cord get sucked up into it. Hold the cord back. And I showed them how to do it. Not that fast, obviously, but I showed them how to do it, and I stepped back and let them do it. And I think that is another part of being a good leader, is letting your people do the work and letting them learn on their own. It's very easy as a parent to try to micromanage your kids. Just yesterday, I let my kids mop. I have this new mop that I absolutely love. It's called an O-Cedar mop if you want to go look on Amazon for it, or maybe Walmart. I'm sure other places have it, but it's called an O-Cedar mop, and I love it because it makes mopping so much fun and so easy. I know it sounds weird, but it's great. Anyway, so I decided to let them help me, and I took the laundry room and I showed them how to work the mop and how to mop the floor, and then I gave it to my three-year-old and she went to work on it, but she wasn't doing it the way I wanted her to do it. But then in my head I thought, okay, I really had to back off because she's learning. She's doing it her own way, and that's okay. So I backed off, had to take a breath. It's okay. The floor is getting mopped, the floor is getting clean. Let's let her work. And I watched her, and she was very meticulous about it. She went over the floor. She didn't go, you know, back and forth. She kind of went like, you know, all around. But she went back and looked, and she's like, oh, it's dry here. Oh, it's dry here. Oh, it's dry here. And she got the floor clean, and my five-year-old did the same. And when we walk around on the floor today, it actually feels really clean. You get what I mean? I also think that being in the military made me mentally tough. Let's be honest, parenting is hard. Parenting is very difficult. There are times where I think I'm failing as a parent. I am not doing something right. Why are they doing this? Why is this happening? And mentally, I just have to bring myself back to this place of, it's gonna be okay. We're gonna get through this. You know, you have to endure. Patient, another word for patience is long suffering. It takes a while and it's suffering, but that's just parenthood. And I think that being in the military made me mentally tough to see things through no matter how hard they get. Being in the military also helped me to value structure and boundaries. Most experts and parents would agree, I think, that structure is good for children. Not too much, they still need time to play, but just this idea of having an order to our day and an order in our home and certain rules that everybody can follow, that structure is good. The transition for me coming out of the military to being a mom was very difficult because the scale on which children operate is very, very different from the scale that adults operate on. I often have to step back and ask myself, am I being too rigid with my kids? Was that the best way to handle it? Is there another way to handle it? I try not to overthink it too much, but I always want to make sure that I'm doing my best, which is, I think, something else the military teaches you. One of the core values of the Air Force is excellence in all we do. So I think that in many ways it beat a good work ethic into me. And I do think that even though I'm a stay-at-home mom and a homeschool mom and a stay-at-home wife, I do try my best every day because I want to communicate this idea of a good work ethic to my kids. And I want to go back just a minute to this idea of leadership and delegating. I think I've fallen into this trap before of wanting to do everything myself because I can get it done faster and more efficiently and better than my children could. But again, as a leader, as a mother, I have to remind myself that it's important that they help me out with this work. It's important to remain connected with my children, and letting them get involved in what I'm doing maintains that connection. It makes them want to obey, makes them want to do what I've asked them to do or what I've told them to do. I like to ask myself, how can I get my kids involved? Or why can't they help me? Now don't get me wrong, there are times I just want to do things by myself. Sometimes at dinner, that's just my time to throw on a YouTube video and go to town making dinner. But generally, I try to let my kids get involved and spend as much time as I can with them during the day. My last point ties into several of the things that I've already talked about. When you're a homeschool mom of three small children, managing their needs and all of the other things that go along with running a household, time management is so important. Children do not operate on the same timeline as adults. They don't really have a concept of time like we do. When I say, it's time to go, let's put our shoes on, they might think we have all the time in the world. Whereas I'm like, we have to leave in 5 minutes, let's go. I had to take a step back and ask myself, how can I help my children get out the door on time, but also not rush them and be like, let's go, let's go, let's go. So Again, another way that I use my military training is finding creative solutions. So what I do is anytime we have to be somewhere, I set my timer about 30 minutes before we have to leave. And when that timer goes off, everything stops and we start getting ready to go. Usually this is when we're going someplace within 5 to 10 minutes of our home. Now, if it's longer, I'll probably set a more appropriate time. But in general, I set a 30-minute timer, and when that timer goes off, we're getting ready to go. I tell my kids, hey, here's some things you might want to put in your backpack. And I let them do it themselves. That way they can get in the habit of doing that. I try to offer them a lot more independence, like just making sure they have stuff and then they get it together themselves. That's a great way to build responsibility in them. Again, training. So my final thought is that whatever background a mother comes from, I think there are always skills that are transferable to motherhood or parenthood if you're a father. Just as skills are transferable from job to job, so they are transferable from job to parenthood. Because let's be honest, parenting is a job. It is probably the most important job we will ever do. Those are just some ways that I've applied the skills and experiences that I had in the military to being a mom. I'm sure there are a lot of other ways that I haven't thought of, but I just wanted to share those few that came to mind. My hope is that in the future, I can apply some of my traveling experiences. We actually have done that a lot stateside. I will say something that just came to mind: when I was away from home or overseas, I traveled a lot. I loved getting out and seeing new things and experiencing the culture and the people and the towns of where I was. And I think I'm handing that off to my children, because a couple times a year, my family will travel to different places. If you go back just a few weeks, I actually posted a video of our trip to Alexandria, and there was such a cultural difference there. We loved it. We loved traveling down there and just experiencing that part of the country, because it is truly a unique part of the country. I would never have, I only would have read about it in a book. I never would have experienced it. So that's something else that I hope to give to my children, is just this love of travel and learning how to do it and do it on a budget and do it efficiently, and how to get away from the touristy things and go where the locals go, and just truly experiencing travel as I've done it in the past. So that is my video, and thank you for watching. And I'm curious, what are some ways that you have applied your experiences and job skills to parenting? I'm very curious. Let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have a good day.